If you're digging for a living, you really need good, reliable tools so that you can be more competitive, get jobs done quicker, and make more money. Over the years, the machine manufacturers have spent millions of dollars improving excavator technology and creating advancements to their engines that increase power, are more fuel efficient, and produce less greenhouse emissions. And whilst machines have become more reliable, have you ever wondered why your fuel usage, efficiency costs, and operating costs haven't really come down that much? Unfortunately, as you'll see in our next short video of our latest test, machine technology has far exceeded most bucket technology. And the majority of excavator buckets on the market haven't changed over the last 50 years, are of poor design and undermine the manufacturer's design and the machine's capabilities. John Lander from Lander Civil in Brayside in Melbourne's southeast. He just wanted to find out how he could optimise the performance of his Hitachi machines. So we took his ZX220 and ZX55 to a local landfill site and tested them out using one of his own operators. We started off with a Hitachi ZX220 using Lander Civil's existing 900mm GP bucket and dug a trench around 2 metres deep for an hour. We then measured the fuel usage and then dug another trench beside the first one using our own 900mm bucket, again for an hour, and measured the fuel usage. The ZX220 with Lander's existing bucket dug 63.2 metres in the time at an average depth of 1.87 metres, which works out to be 106.4 cubic metres of material in that hour and used 15 litres of fuel. The eiengineering bucket dug 83 metres at an average depth of 2 metres, which equals a massive 149.4 cubic metres and still used only 15 litres of fuel. That's a massive 41% more in just 1 hour. Now, looking from a savings perspective, using the eiengineering bucket, the first trench would have been dug in only 42 minutes. This is saving 18 minutes an hour, or 2 hours 15 minutes per day in operator digging time. At $45 an hour in wages, this is a saving of $506 per week. And fuel reflected savings of 4.65 litres an hour, or 33 litres of fuel a day, around $200 per week saved in fuel. The machine working hours would only be 26 hours, 45 minutes in a normal 38-hour week. So if normal servicing is every 250 hours, the servicing intervals increase from 6.5 to 9.5 weeks. And greenhouse emissions would be cut by a third. An increase in productivity of 41%. In a 7-hour, 36-minute day, you will achieve a staggering 327 cubic metres more per day, or 1,635 cubic metres per week extra. 81 20 cubic metre truckloads per week extra. We then did the same test on the ZX55. Unfortunately, we hit some large rocks using Lander Civil's existing bucket, then quite a bit of shale using our own bucket. So it skewed the results significantly and didn't really give a fair comparison for either bucket. Then we ran out of time for the day to start again. But we'll have a rematch soon, so watch this space. But all of this means that the results are consistent with all of our other tests, and that with the EI engineering buckets, you can quote jobs more competitively, reduce your costs, and make more money, and at the same time being environmentally responsible. So stay tuned for the rematch with the Hitachi ZX55 machine. Thanks again to John from Lander Civil for the use of his machines, and we'll look forward to seeing you all again soon.